about some might not, so I'm really excited to be to see it and get your feedback. First of all, I'd like to thank Andy and the Half Open guys for putting this on for us. It's a great venue. I'd just like to invite Andy to say a few words about Half Open, that's all right. This, in another place, might not have worked, but because of Oldham's infrastructure, the way the people are able to really friendly, able to support each other, and the things that the council do at Oldham to help support local businesses, it really was the perfect place to do it. We love Oldham, and eventually it will branch out, but not Oldham's a place to be at the moment, I think anyway. I hope you do too. We'll just click next again, onto how we got started. So it's kind of a year this month that this idea blossomed. I sat down in a coffee shop and I jotted a few ideas down, and it went from there with it. Feedback, some positive, some negative, but we've always come back fighting. So we've always found ways to improve it, improved on it, found different ways to improve it again. So it's such a relief to be here, to have an office, to have an app, to have colleagues that are working on it and as passionate about it as I am, from where we was, you know, 7-8 months ago, when it was just an idea and no one would give us funding at all. Just how we got started. Like I said, it was in a coffee shop and I jotted a few ideas down and I tried to get some funding for it and it just wasn't going our way. I ended up quitting my job because I knew that this idea could work. I really believed in it. I walked to the library every day and I used the library computers to try and learn a bit about code. And I read books about how to start a business and things like that. And it went from there really. Tried to get funding and we couldn't. And then I met a friend how to make this business work. Name's Paul and his team have a chat, and he really took this business from being here up to here, and I can't thank you enough for that. So if we just skip on to kind of what our mission is now, I'd say it's so refreshing from where we was to where we are now, but if we just read this, it's to work collaboratively, alongside every source, every business, every organisation, and every person in order to provide a comprehensive but customizable platform specific to individuals' needs. So there will be a lot of content on there, but because there's a lot of content in the area, there's loads going on, but people don't know about it. So we want to give it to you, but specify it for what you're actually interested in. So that is our goal at the moment. So if we just skip on to the next slide, which is what our plans are for the future. So our plans at the moment is just Oldham. We've really, really focused on Oldham and wanted to make it the best as we possibly can. We will have a phase 2 coming out quite shortly. So you'll see the phase 1 of the app and then we'll get lots of improvements for it. And then the phase 2 will involve a fully functional job board and a property board as well. And hopefully we're going to get some more funding to then eventually skip on to the next phase. Next one, Ellen, please. Which is live on my watch right there. So we've shown that this business is scalable to the Greater Manchester area, and it's slightly different because there's key sources in different areas that we need to tick off in order to get that business to work. But we've planned all this out now. I'm a long way into this now and I've brought it through and it can definitely work. So this is the next step along with the mobile app that we're going to bring out, because we've built a web app which works brilliantly, and then we'll convert it to a mobile app so it works even better. And the final stage is obviously to conquer the UK, but We are small at that right now because we're growing older, but our plans are massive and we want to bring this Oven-based business throughout the country and stay loyal to our locals to still have the older time in there and the older kind of shape, if you will. So that's what our plans are. Thankfully, the staff that we've got in are amazing. They're so passionate about it. I couldn't have asked for better guys. They're the talented ones. I just work really hard and find good staff. That's all I do. So I think this is, with the guys that we've got in and the additions that we'll make, it's definitely doable for us. We'll just skip on to the next slide. Some of the sources and partners that we've made already. So from the start, when we didn't have anything tangible to show someone, it was so difficult to go to someone and say, this is what we're going to make. Will you be interested? And they're like, well, who's this guy? Just coming, you know, what's this about? Now, we've partnered with so many businesses because they can see how it's going to help them and how it's going to help the community. So we've just gone to the next. We've got cinemas, we've got charities, colleges, we've got nightclubs, football clubs. Skip on to the next slide. We've got national companies like Twitter and Monster that we get information from. The Coliseum, Hackham itself is obviously a partner as well. Travelling, the Metro Link, and the next slide. These are businesses that we spoke to and all that our customer feedback said we really want this information on the app. So, jobs. So there's so many different categories of businesses that are interested in it that the interest has just gone through the roof when we have something tangible to show them. So that's what this is about, bringing you and the community a minimal viable product that we can get out there, get your feedback, because as much as we're a commercial business, we're a community business as well. We want as much feedback as possible to make it as good as it can be. We just go to the next slide, which is a sneak peek. That's what we're all here for, to have a look at the app, how it's going to be. So we just skip over to the app to have a look at it. Bear in mind, guys, this is a minimal viable product. It's impressive now. I think it's impressive. But the things that we can do with it, and our experience as we go, opportunities are endless, they really are. So whilst I'm just getting the app up, I'll quickly run through how that will work. Bear in mind how you would use it, how your business might be able to use it, and how your business might be able to use it, and what applications it will have for you guys. Because when we go walk around people, they say it's only something that, you know, we can find all our information from without going to all the different places. That's the goal. And people really are getting behind it. So we'll just wait for the
pressure.
Any questions so far, guys? At all that I can kind of answer? I'd say we're not there yet, but it's a brilliant product to start off with, and we hope that it will continue through. Yeah, go ahead.
Hi, it's Alex from Mudlow. One of the things that we found most encouraging about what you're offering was that it wasn't a case of sitting down and re-inputting things and constantly duplicating work and that you could kind of pull from our calendar and stuff. So I just really wanted to stress that.
Yeah.
And then the fact that for us, obviously getting our message out there is really key, but resource is also a factor of being a charity. So obviously on an ongoing basis, that kind of process of being able to check in with you guys and let you know about updates, but not have to continuously update things is really beneficial.
Yeah, that's what we wanted. We wanted to have good relationships with companies so that they can just pick up the phone and say, I want to do this with the app, is it doable? Can you automate this for us? Can you basically give us an online presence because we don't have a website? So there's lots of the pubs out there that don't have websites, there's cafes that don't have websites, but people need to know where they are, what they're offering, what deals they can make, and they need people through the door. So there's not really many businesses that can get someone to go into the business and say, we will fill this place up. If you've had a cancellation of 20 people, put the thing out online all room, and we will fill it up, we guarantee it. And we will stand by that. The more we grow, the better it will get. So let's just make through a preview, minimal viable product of Live All Room. So this is the home screen. We've got three buttons at the bottom. This is a What's On page. So on the What's On page, you'll be able to have featured and sponsored events and organisations. So different organisations will pay a certain amount to be on the first on this list. So if you have an event, a big event, or if you want to get the most people you can through your restaurant doors or something like that, you might have a sponsored event on this page. Also on the right, we've got a map signal. So if you click on the map real quick, you'll be able to see where you are on the map and where different organisations are and where different events are. So you might be in Oldham Town Centre Monday and you might want different restaurants in the area. So you can filter that and say, here's the nearest restaurants, here are the nearest restaurants that are offering 2-for-1, here's the nearest bars that are offering 30% off, that kind of thing. So the map is a really cool function that you could use walking down the street. If we go over to the organisations page, so this page just shows us different categories of organisations. So if you're looking for someone, if you're looking for a plumber or an accountant or a restaurant, it comes to this page, you select the category. If we go to food, for example, it comes up with loads of different companies that you can choose from. So we're going to go to the navigation bar at the top, where we have some different links with kind of community links. So these pages, if you go to the travel page, this is kind of showing you what we'll be able to bring the user. So if you go to trams, you can select, it will bind to your nearest tram stop, or you can select a tram stop and it'll give you the line times. And we can't only just do this with trams, we can do it with bus times, taxis, coaches. We can automatically bring this data in. So if you need to travel anywhere, you'll just come to LiveOrb. Same with anything else, you'll also come to LiveOrb, as I'm showing here. If you go to the navigation bar at the top, and go to news. Here we display all sorts of news. So we've got the Chronicle open at the moment as our local news outlet. But you'll be able to see lots of different news outlets. So if you're interested in sport, you'll be able to see the news in sport. If you're not, you won't. You can customise it to exactly how you want it. And you can see it looks really good as well. So you can get a small snippet and you click through to the Chronicle's article because we want to drive as much traffic to the Chronicle as possible because we believe that the Chronicle is such a big thing for Oldham and we're really behind them. So the more traffic we can give to the Chronicle, the better. And just a navigation bar at the top again, and we'll go to entertainment this time, and all cinemas. So these are cinema times, really popular for the area, especially with the new cinema opening up. We have got a few tickets to give away later on, but it comes up with all the cinema times for that day, and you can select a date as well. So these are the kind of examples of pages that we can set up that are fixed information that are available all the time. And when you just want to look at a certain business, we can do that as well. So if you go to the navigation page and go to organisations again, and we'll head to food again, because food's quite a nice one. There's lots of interest on there, and lots of images, and there's lots of choice as well, because all we're doing at the moment, there's loads of food places available, and they're all amazing. So we scroll down to, let's say, Joyburg Kitchen. So we click into this, and this gives that organisation a page. So as I was saying before, some people don't have websites. This is an opportunity for them to get online and tell people what they do without having to pay loads of money for a website. So this is an organisation. There's an about section which will give you a slight snippet of what that business is about, where to find them, and show you a map of the information. It also gives you some images below the map, which the organisation can add themselves as well. They want to show off a little bit about what they do. And then if you skip to the social page, at the top, so this aggregates all the social media from that particular organisation and puts it on one platform, so you don't have to skip through all the different Twitters and Facebooks to find out what's going on. So if you look, this is Instagram, it goes through all their Instagram feed. If you fly through it, you'll come to the Twitter page as well, it comes to all the Twitter, because businesses are present on social media at the moment, so we might as well display all of them for you to see them in one place. No one else is doing this at the moment for people. So this goes through all the Twitter, we keep scrolling down, so you have live off the top of their Twitter, and this is their Google Places information, so opening times, busy times, stuff like that. It'll give you kind of a snapshot of their social media presence. You can also have YouTube videos on there, because it'll link to YouTube channel. So that's kind of a snapshot about what an organisation's page looks like. Now, if we head over to the navigation page, and so you've got all the images there. Now, next we'll click on events, because you want to know what's going on in the area. You can categorise it as we can with children, male, female, outdoors, nightlife, health. So we go to food again, head to food, and let's see what events are going on at the moment in Oldham for food. So GBK have got a live offer on, 30% off when you spend £20, and these can be automatically notified to people's phones, pinged by emails, WhatsApp, text messages, That's how kind of advanced this is. And this will only be specific to things that you're interested in. People can have thousands of Facebook followers, but are they quality followers? Are they people that are genuinely interested in that business? Whereas this, you'll be following the business to get live updates, to get when the offers are on, to get real-time information for exactly what you're interested in. So the final feature I want to send you to is the search feature, top left. So this is really clever. If you just type in CA, it brings up all different information that have CA in it. So you can be looking for an event, or you can be looking for films to watch, or an organisation, it comes up with all that information for you. If you start looking camera for me, so camera is an organisation that's related to pubs. So you are a camera member if you're a pub. So this is an example of tags. So we can do this, these pubs come up under camera with pub quizzes. You'll be able to see what pubs have pub quizzes on. Happy hours, Sky Sports News, things like that. You can use these tags and you'll be able to search for anything. So if you want to search for children's events, if you want to search for swimming, for children, these tags will be able to allow you to filter the information as much as you possibly can to get a small list of events that are available to you. And it won't just be for a select business, it will be for everyone. Because the technology that we've learned, Paul Cummins, as my mentor, he's an expert in automation, and there isn't anyone that can do what we do at the moment, because it is. So that's the gist of what the app is going to be. We will be adding much more features, but we want the features to come from the community as well. We want, how is it going to work for your business? How is it going to work for you as a user? And then we'll adapt it to that, because like I say, we are a community business. We want all of them to do well, but we want to branch out to the area and make a business from all of them massive. That is our aim. So that's it for me. I hope it's give you, a gist about what we're doing, because even my own family don't really know what's going on. So what are you doing then? So now I hope you get a bit of a gist. Massive thanks to you guys, because you've supported me really well. It's been a struggle because I haven't taken a wage for more than 9 months now, because we've been trying to get this business off the ground, but my partner Rose has pushed me every step of the way. I've been an absolute nightmare. She pays for everything. But I really appreciate everything that you guys do. All the staff at Live Over and the partners and you guys for showing up. I really appreciate it. We want you guys in the app as family members and bigger and better things to come. I really appreciate it. Thanks, guys. Woo!
The chance of something that they really believe in. So thank you for inviting me. I really enjoyed it. And it's really good to see what's going on all about. And I wish you all the very best.
There is a raffle going on. I don't know if you've got a ticket. If you haven't got one, go and get one, because there's some really cool prizes that we're giving away. And there'll be some cakes and more dessert type food after this, the food that's has been there. So I'm sure a couple of my friends will eat most of it. So don't let them. So yeah, again, thanks to everyone. We really, really, really appreciate it. I hope you have a good night. Cheers, guys.